Ever since the dawn of human civilization, we have become beings that are capable of critical thinking. We developed the cognitive abilities to seek meaning in life, to believe in things we've never seen. Something that our fellow companions on Earth lack. Since the beginning of society, people have wondered if we are alone in the universe or whether there is intelligent life like us somewhere else. Beings who live among the stars. In the late 20th century, scientists converged upon the basic idea of scanning the sky and listening for non-random patterns of electromagnetic emissions, such as radio or television waves, in order to detect another possible civilization somewhere else in the universe. In 1960, astronomer Frank Drake pointed the Green Bank Observatory's giant radio telescope at two sun-like stars for 150 hours in the hopes of finding some hint of alien life. While Drake's search was unsuccessful, it prompted humanity's ongoing quest to observe the cosmos in an effort to answer a massive existential question. Are we alone in the universe? Drake's initial quest to find alien life led to the foundation of the SETI, Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, which is a series of programs that aims to look for intelligent life beyond our solar system, mostly by trying to eavesdrop on their radio signals. But throughout the history of SETI, the interference of human-caused radio signals has been a persistent problem. Finding actual extraterrestrial signals, if they do exist out there, is not an easy task. Think of it as looking for a needle in a haystack. How do we filter out the noise and find what actually matters? How do we distinguish the radio signals coming from space from the uninteresting radio signals from Earth? Astronomers needed a new method for detecting techno signatures and radio signals. This is where a scientist called Peter Marr and his team from the University of Toronto came in. With artificial intelligence technology that made it possible to detect potential alien signals.
Orbit beyond the blue.
The scientists developed a new machine learning algorithm that can better pick out potential alien signals from all the background noise on Earth. This initial search went through data from 820 nearby stars, totaling over 480 hours of on-sky data taken with the Robert C. Byrd Green Bank Telescope as part of the Breakthrough Listen initiative. So, how does the machine learning tool work? Basically, the researchers trained the algorithm to differentiate between potential alien signals and human-caused ones by simulating both types of signals. Steve Croft, project scientist for Breakthrough Listen on the Green Bank Telescope, said, "The key issue with any techno signature search is looking through this huge haystack of signals to find the needle that might actually be a transmission from an alien world. The vast majority of the signals detected by our telescopes originate from our own technology, GPS satellites, mobile phones, and the like. Peter's algorithm gives us a more effective way to filter the haystack and find signals that have the characteristics we expect from techno signatures." The scientists searched 820 nearby stars from the Hipparchos catalogue for possible techno signatures. And surprisingly, they already found something. The 8 signals appeared to originate from the direction of 5 of the stars, ranging from 30 to 90 light years away. Although they haven't been proven for certain to be extraterrestrial, they are certainly interesting. Scientists explained that this means that they have key characteristics that make them look like alien signals, but we cannot be certain yet. More analysis is required. There's one issue though. Follow-up observations attempted so far haven't been able to see the signals again. The astronomers will need to detect them again in order to study them more closely and try to determine if they actually are from deep space or just terrestrial interference. Astronomers had previously detected Breakthrough Listen's first candidate signal, called BLCI, in 2020, It seemed to come from the direction of the closest star to the Sun, which has Earth-like planets Proxima Centauri. But this signal was later traced to earthly interference. And before that, back in 1977, a strong narrowband signal was detected by Ohio State University's Big Ear telescope. The signal appeared to come from the direction of the constellation Sagittarius and bore the expected hallmarks of extraterrestrial origin. Hence, it was named the WOW signal. The entire signal sequence lasted for the full 72-second window, during which Big Ear was able to observe it, but has not been detected since, despite several subsequent attempts. Many theories have been advanced on the origin of the emission, including natural, alien, and human-made sources, but none of them adequately explain the signal. The WOW signal remains, as of July 2022, the strongest candidate for an extraterrestrial radio transmission ever detected. But now, if astronomers are able to confirm the existence of these 8 signals definitively this time around, then these will go down in history as the first ever alien signals detected and confirmed. If not signals, then a few scientists have plenty more hypotheses for how aliens could contact us. One such hypothesis is that highly evolved civilizations could alter the orbits of planets in its solar system to serve as a beacon of its presence to an observer from the outside. The gravitational pull of asteroids might be used to slowly move planets into new places over thousands of years, causing them to have full orbits relative to one another in a specific fixed ratio or resonance. Natural gravitational interactions produce such resonance. For example, Jupiter's moon Io completes 4 Jupiter orbits for every 2 Europa orbits and 1 Ganymede orbit, forming a 2:1 resonance chain. Similar patterns have been observed in other star systems, although those in which the ratios of each body differ rather than creating chains have never been observed. As a result, the researchers believe aliens may organize their planets in sequences that are unlikely to occur naturally, such as a prime number series 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, etc., or the Fibonacci sequence 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, and so on. The researchers calculated that these relative orbits may persist for 20 billion years before losing resonance, even surviving the demise of their host star. Now the concept is quite similar to colossal structures on Earth, such as ancient Egypt's tallest pyramids, which were built to last beyond the lifetime of a civilization. This beacon, too, could have the potential to outlast its creators. Even if we did uncover such a sequence, it wouldn't prove intelligent life, and it's possible that the civilization behind it has long since vanished. But the relics of it might still be found. So, alien signals or planetary orbit patterns, or something entirely else? What will it be? Whatever it is, we hope the first contact happens soon. But what do I know?
Beyond the blue.